Commander Hugh Jardim here. Welcome to another one of my Elite Dangerous videos. This one's another one about pirate massacre missions because I've been getting a few questions about them. Some people are unsure about some things. So I thought I'd put a bit more meat on the bone and give you a video on how to do it in a sort of fully optimized way. There's loads of like tips and tricks which could all save a little bit of time and maybe get you a bit of extra money and things like that. So if you want to see those, carry on watching. The previous videos, well, it's one mainly, beginner's guide to pirate massacre mission. So the basic method is all in there and nothing's changed since then. But this is just how to do it better. So where do we start? Yeah, now to get the most money, you need a good spawn of ships, which I'm going to show you later. So you're aiming to get about 50 to 60 pirates, mission targets an hour. So you get double that in pirates, but 60 is a good number. And each time you go to the place where you kill them, the spawn is slightly different. I'm going to show you exactly how to make it so that it's how you want it. But what that's important for is you need to match it to how many missions you take. You can take 20 missions, and so you can load it up with quite a few pirates. I explained all about keeping it in balance before. There's five factions that give the missions, and you want to aim to get the same number of mission targets from each one, because each one pirate that you kill, mission target one, it'll count for all five factions as long as you've got a mission open for them. So when you take, say, so let's say you've got a spawn of 60 targets an hour, then if you take missions for 60 pirates from each faction, then it's going to take you an hour to kill them all before you can come back again. And if you take 120, it's going to take you 2 hours, and 183 hours. And if you only get a spawn of 50, it's going to take you roughly 20% longer. So your earnings rate depends on the spawn rate, and your play session time depends on how many you take from the worst the faction with the highest number you take, because it's impossible to keep them exactly in balance. You can't get exactly 60 or 120 from each. You know, you're going to end up with like 130 from one, 120. But it's the highest one that's going to determine your play time. Because, I mean, you can do it in two sessions, but you've got to bear in mind that a lot of the higher paying missions time out after roughly a day. So if you took them out at the end of the play session, you know, after you go back to port, after you've completed, you'll be ready for the next night. But if you miss a night, they'll all time out and you'll lose all your rep. So just bear that in mind when you take all the missions. So when you first arrive, you won't have any rep. So you won't get those full paying missions. You're going to have to do some of the missions to like rep your way up as ever. Also, the amount they pay depends on your combat rank. So my friend is mostly harmless. He's been coming here, and the same missions for him pay half as much. But if you're going to do them like, yeah, you know, it's not the sort of thing you want to do just once. You need to like do it for a bit to get the best out of it. And even if you're like low combat rank, it will quite quickly increase. It's a sort of exponential thing. So you make a lot of progress at the beginning, and then the rate of progress slows down. So I'm not too sure how much up you got to go to get like decent powers. All I know is I'm elite and I get the maximum, and he's mostly harmless, and the same missions pay half as much for him. Now, if you're excluded from doing any missions because you don't have the rep, you'll see them down the bottom of the page, you know, saying you don't qualify. There are some donation missions that come from time to time. It's worth doing those to get the rep. And then when you cash them in, you want to prioritize the rep. It's like an investment. You don't get so much money, but what the next time you got more chance of getting a higher paying mission when you're fully repped up. So I don't know all the figures and the details and things, but that's it in a nutshell. The more rep you got, the more money you get for them, and the higher the combat rank, the more money you get for them. I just want to show you the mission board that I've got here. It's a particularly bad one. These are the five factions: Eightvas, Empire Party, Patrons of Law, Jet, and the War Grannies. So if you just look at Eightvas, there's no pirate missions. None here either. Patrons of Law, we've got some. Jet, we've got a few. And War Grannies. So typically there'd be three each time. Now, if you're doing it on your own, not in a wing, these are the best missions. What you're looking for is a non-wing one, roughly 41 million, and it's going to be to kill always 30 pirates. If you're doing it in a wing, the ones you're looking for, I did see one somewhere here, roughly 39 million for, and that would be for 81 pirates. Because if you're doing it with somebody else, they get one of those as well. You share them with each other. And so between you kill 81 pirates, but you're going to get your 39 million and your wingmate's 39 million. So you got double the money. So with the wing missions, you have to kill roughly two pirates for each million. And for a non-wing one, just slightly less than one. So they're the two missions you should be looking for, but you don't get enough of them. As you can see, there's like one of each at the moment on this board at the moment. So what you do, you take those, and then every time the clock reaches exactly 10 minutes on this one, so it's on 46, and then when it comes to 50, the board will refresh. But actually, I've overrun the last one, so I've passed the last 10 minutes. So when I close it and open it up again, we now got different missions because I've got the 40-minute one here now. So let's have a look. Eightvas, still none from them. Still none from them. And then here, nothing particularly special there. Well, I told you what the best missions are. It's going to take you a while. You get the feel of them. You know, that's quite a good one if you're in a wing. And so what your aim is to like fill up with the 40 million ones for 30 pirates and the 20 million ones for 15 pirates. So it's the same earnings rate. And then when you can't get any from the other factions, they're only giving wing missions, then you take a few wing missions from them. So just to get as much value in the missions you can whilst sort of restricting the number of pirates you're going to do to your play session. You need to do a little bit of maths and figuring out and stuff like that. So let me just have a look, see what else we've got. So they're all medium sort of wing missions. I just use those for filling up. War Grannies are offering all wing missions. So if you're not in a wing, you know, it's a question of how long you want to spend stacking the missions. Because as I said, each 10 minutes they refresh and you get another chance. And you're looking for the 40 million for 30, 20 million for 15. There's also 21 million for 25. These are all non-wing ones. And if you're going to do a wing one, wing ones with a friend, obviously you want the ones with the biggest payout. It's as simple as that. But there's going to be more pirates with them. So if you don't want, you know, if you're going to do 81 pirates in a session, obviously you can only take one from a faction. So that's basically the missions. I'm already full up, so I can't really show you any more with that. But what I do, I play in the evening, kill all my pirates, come back, cash in, and then when I've finished, you know, it's still an hour before I close down my computer because I'll be looking at some forums and maybe watching a video or something like that. So I just leave the game running and then you just check it every 10 minutes. You have a little notepad by you, record all the missions you got. Just, you know, I write down the five factions and how many pirates I got to get for each mission I take. So I always know how many from each. And then when I've finished, you know, normally an hour is enough to, you know, get your 20 missions for tomorrow. Now, the mission board, depending on a lot of circumstances, things, it comes and goes. Factions come and go with how many missions are going to offer. So just be patient. Those two, Patrons of Law, sorry, that wasn't one, was it? It was eight vests. You aren't offering any. You know, in about two refreshes time, you'll click it and suddenly it'll just be full up. So get them all while you can. And then the next refresh, they'll be gone again. So just be patient. And you're going to need quite a few refreshes to fill up. Of course, you know, if you just want to go out there for an hour, you want to mess about it, just take the ones that's there and go and do them. But you're not going to make the most money like that. I'm making roughly 500 to 600 million a night, and it's taking about 2 to 2.5 hours from the time I leave the station to the time I come back. And then there's about another hour, maybe half an hour before I start, while I'm having my tea, you know, I get my tea, eat it. And while I'm doing that, I'm doing the last couple of refreshes to make sure I'm like absolutely full. And then when I finish my tea, put it down and off I go to kill the pirates. So that's about it for the mission. Now, I just want to show you the ships, because they're different to what I've showed you before. And I did talk about them. Where are we? This one. So, the best ship, as far as I can figure out, I think is the Chieftain. These three that I'm going to show you, there isn't a lot in it. So, you know, choose whichever one you want or your favourite. They each have advantages and disadvantages over the other. But overall, I think the Chieftain just edges it. So have a look at this loadout. If I remember, I'll post a direct link to it in the comments so you can just click on it and see it. And you probably know how Inara works. Just hover over the engineering to see what's in it. Sorry, not Inara, Coriolis. There it is, https://coriolis.io. You don't have to worry about all that. You can experiment with your own builds and things like that. We're going to show you what the important things are. Right. First of all, it's absolutely vital that your ship is as fast as possible, because you're going to have to keep jumping from one side of the place to the other, 12 kilometers. So good couple of boosts. And also you're going to have to chase a lot of ships that's running away from you. It just saves time. You know, if you want to earn at the fastest rate, you have to chase them down quickly. And a small difference in speed makes a big difference in the time, because they're running away from you all the time. It's just a question of how quickly you catch them. So first of all, speed is important. Shields, not so important. I reckon 2,000 megajoules and you're still pretty safe. The more you've got, the better. So these ships all have optimized shields for their size. So that's one advantage of Chieftain, but it does seem to take a little bit more damage than the other one. So it doesn't end up any stronger. So you'll see it's a complete shield tank. Every spare shot slot is full up with Guardian shield reinforcements, which you need. Like, so if you haven't got those unlocked, you know, it's not the end of the world, because it'll still probably be strong enough, but you're better with them. So the rest of it is shield boosters. In this case, they're all resistance augmented, if I remember rightly. Yeah, with super capacitors. That gives you the optimum thermal resistance. This is the main one, because they're low-grade enemies that are going to be shooting you with mainly lasers and occasionally missiles. So hence the point defense. Jury's out on that, whether another shield booster would be better. I think it's six and a half a dozen. But quite a few of the targets fire missiles at you. And so you want a point defense, as much pointing forward as you can, because you're going to be face tanking them while they're firing missiles at you and you're shooting them. So the point defense on the front, I think it does give a little bit of help. But on this, the shields are so strong, it's academic, really. So anything else? Always bi-weave shields engineered for thermal with fast charge. Other important thing, sensors need to be as longer range as possible, so always A-grade with the long range modification. power distributor always charge enhanced with super conduits for maximum charge rate. So we've got fast charge shields, point defense. I'll come to the weapons in a minute. Power plant just needs to be enough to power everything. This engineering, I think you can get away with one overcharged. Frameshift drive isn't that important. I haven't even engineered it on this one. It's giving you 17 light gains. Of course, you can if you want to do it for more. Then in that case, you might need grade 3 overcharged or something like that for the power plant. And the life support doesn't matter at all. I've done it lightweight. Gives you, I think, 1 meter a second extra speed. So every little helps. So that's the basic principles of the loadout. So now we go to the FAS, which is also a very good ship. It's a bit weird because the two main pulse lasers... Oh, I haven't done the weapons yet. So, sorry. Let me just go back to chiefdom. Now the burst lasers. This one's all burst lasers. It gives you the most firepower you can get without having to go back for ammo. And the engineering on the three big ones is efficient. That gives you extra damage and less power consumption and flow control. The other three, this is very important, are long range with flow control. Flow control to reduce the power consumption. And long range, because you're going to be shooting a lot of targets which are out of range of normal lasers. I don't know, it shows down the bottom. How do we do it? Offense down here, I think, isn't it? No, profiles. You see the weapons damage. So these are the long range ones, goes right up to 6 kilometers. The other ones, the efficient ones, the damage is dropping off after 500 meters. And you'll be spending a lot of time shooting at this sort of range. So that's how much they damage. So you can see that the small long-range ones are doing nearly as much damage as the medium one at 1,500 meters. So unfortunately, you can't do them all long-range because you don't have enough power. So it's a compromise between distributed draw and damage and range. So you definitely need long range. Again, you're chasing the targets down. They'll be out of range. And being able to land a shot at a distance helps a lot. Also, the police are going to be shooting some of your targets while you're shooting another one. And you need to be able to turn around and shoot them immediately, the target that is, to get credited with the kill, even though the police finish it off. And if it's more than 3 kilometres away, you won't be able to land a shot. So... You'd be out on that one. So there we go. This is all burst lasers, three efficient, three long range, all with flow control. Right. So now we go to the FAS. As I say, these two lasers are top and bottom. It's a bit weird. I'm coming in. And you have to point exactly at the target for all the lasers to land. So be mindful of that. If you're pointing too high, only the bottom one will fire, and too low, only the top one will. And even the side ones, you know, it's quite difficult to land them all. You have to be pointing exactly at the target to do the maximum damage. But on the plus side, the Federal Assault Ship is very fast at pointing to your targets. It's, you know, one of the best pointing ships in the game, where you just turn your thing and point at them and it's there. Like other ships are drifting about all over the place, and the target's going behind you, and you, by the time you've turned, it's back in front of you again, you know, all that sort of thing. The FAS doesn't do that. You just turn, point, and shoot. And that's why this is highly recommended. Also, it's very fast. You can see, again, we're over 550 meters per second, which is the sort of speed you need. So the rest of it is very similar to the other one. All the things are the same. I'm not going to go through them at all. Same sensors, same point defense. I think in this one, one of the shield boosters needs to be heavy duty, I think. Resistance augmented. Oh, never quite shows. Heavy duty, yeah, to get the maximum shields. It makes a small difference, that's all. What else? That's still fast charge, thermal. The docking computer's optional, you know, like it just speeds things up at the end of the session, you know, landing quickly and whatever. So I don't think there's anything else about this one. Then the vulture. Now the vulture, its strong point is I mean, all the ships have similar characteristics, that they're good at pointing and have massive lateral thrusters to get in the right position all the time and to avoid incoming fire. The vulture really excels at that. So we're lacking in a bit in firepower, but its position, it gets closer all the time. It's much more responsive on the speed net, so it's dead easy to stay close. And the closer you are with any type of laser, the more damage you do. So what you lose out by not having so many lasers, you can get closer, so you do more damage. This is why this, as I said, there's not a lot between these ships. It's just a question of what you can afford, what you got access to, and well, I think on balance, as I said, I think the Chieftain is the best, but I can't say. I had a session in the Vulture where I completed a massive number in a very short time. My record was on the Vulture, so jury's still out on it. You do have weaker shields, but again, you don't take so much fire, so that's not really a problem. Now, the Vulture's always short on power, so in this case, we have to do a bit of power management, put the frameshift drive on a lower priority than the others, so that switches off when you get your weapons out. So the only thing is, at the end of the session, when you put your weapons away, you just got to wait a few seconds before your frameshift drive is able to charge to get out of there. But this is the ultimate. You can maybe cut down somewhere else. I mean, you could save the docking computer. I don't know whether that makes a difference. The power plant is already. Yeah, I got thermal spread. Vulture doesn't run too hot with this loadout, so you could go for monstered on that to get a bit more power if that does you in. Also, I've got a D frameshift driver with only 12, 13 light years jump range. And that's not a problem because you're only going to be traveling 3 light years, but it is a problem if you press the wrong button and end up in jail. Because it's a long way to the jail, and with only 13 light years, it's going to be many jumps to get back. That's how people get caught out in short jump range. But if you're working from a fleet carrier or something like that, jump range is never going to be an issue. So for the actual activity, jump range doesn't matter, but it will in other circumstances. Right, so that's it for the ships. So finally, before we go out, there's a couple of prerequisites. You need to make sure you've got a button bound to next hostile target. I mean, yeah, I don't know how you play. Some people have buttons bound to everything. You can have previous target, next target, highest threat, any of those things. But all you need, the minimum you need, and I never use anything more, is next hostile target. And you can, as long as you've got that, a very easy access button, you can very quickly scroll through all the targets you've got and choose the one you want to shoot, which is quite important. What else is there? Oh, the other thing, turn off crimes against me over this side. I can't remember where it is now. I think it's in ship somewhere, is it? There it is. Third one down. Report crimes against me. Oh, it's on. How'd that come on? You want it off because it's interesting, it's not doing it. Because you don't want the police stealing your targets. You can easily deal with everything that's going to be shooting at you. If you have the crimes on, if you've got shooting a wing, the moment you shoot the first one, the other two start shooting back at you. And then with crimes on, the police will come in and help you. But you don't want that because they're going to get them before you do if you're not careful, because they do blow up a little bit easy, some of them. So keep that off, and mainly the police will leave you alone. Right, this is the target system. As I said, it's only one small jump. And immediately you want to disregard all the blue writing and advice about where to go to kill the things. Head straight for Planet 5, which is the last one. Now you might get interdicted, so if you do, fight the interdiction. It's not worth fighting the ship. It'll be an elite, well, it'll be a high-ranking one, depending on your own rank, be well-equipped for combat, and often they have shield cell banks, so they take a long time to whittle down. You want to steer out. When you point at this target, Mainani 5, you'll see some planets to the side of it in a little group. So steer to the other side, a bit of a gap, to sort of like loop round those planets because they slow you down on the way in. So you see, I just like corrected now because I've gone past. They're about 45 seconds. So once you get to 40 seconds, you can straighten up. So I don't know whether to get into it, but always fight it because it's going to be a long battle for one pirate. Whereas when you get into the resource extraction site, there'll be loads of easy to kill ones, hopefully. Right, so as we get closer, we can now target the low resource extraction site, not the hazardous one. Because again, there'll be high rank ships at the hazardous. You can kill a few, but it's very slow, obviously, by comparing with the low one. And you still get some good battles, you know, it's still a bit of fun doing this. You get wings of competent ships and, you know, two at a time sometimes, so. And it gives you a chance to sort of perfect your techniques because things tend to happen more in slow motion. You know, a good chance to practice your use of your thrusters and stuff like that if you're not used to that. Yeah, even when it's daylight in there, the lights being on helps light up the ships better so that you can see better to shoot them. And of course, sometimes it's dark and you can't do anything when it's dark. So here we are, we're in. Hopefully we're near the thing. Now what you're looking for straight away is square tops. They tend to be mission targets already. So get your weapons out. So a vulture is a good sign. That's a big ship spawn. So it's got a mission target already. Just a question of pointing and shooting. Get as close as you can. They'll fly behind you. I'm going to show you some tactics in a minute. But first of all, just while I'm talking and thinking, just point and shoot. Boom, he's gone. So any with a square top has just dropped in. So there's another one. And it's an anaconda. Right, with an anaconda, first you scan them, and then you want to target their power plant. You can either do that in the left panel, which takes a bit longer, or have a button or a scroll wheel to scroll through them. I use a scroll wheel on this stick, it's brilliant. So he's a novice, so probably his power plant won't go fast, so go up to him. What an anaconda, you want to try and get sideways on like this. So I'm at full throttle, but I'm holding the down thruster. That if he leans towards me from the top, down thrust, and if he leans away, up thrust. You want to stay sideways on like this, so that you're pummeling his power plant all the time. Boom, he's gone at 30%, see, so that saved a bit of time. So now, oh, there's another square top up there. Just turn, if they just turn triangle, the moment you sort of go to target them, there's a fair chance it's a pirate. So here we go, sidewinder. They can take just as long as an anaconda. Every ship has its advantages and disadvantages. So don't think they're always an easy target. Right, so now we've dealt with probably the initial ones. So what you've got to do is have a look around now, right, target a few. So police are shooting that one, so he's obviously a pirate. So you can wait till you see wanted to before you start. But you don't really have to, you know, if the police are shooting him. So another quick way to identify a target. There's another square top there. Not all square tops will be mission targets, so don't get caught out, but they're the ones you want to look at first. I don't necessarily mean mission targets, but pirates. So normally half the pirates are mission targets. So we can start shooting them. It's a novice. The ranks don't really make that much difference. Only thing with an anaconda, generally the competent ones, targeting their power plant works. The novice and harmless ones, they their hull tends to go first. Right, so who have we got? So, just now target the ships. Whether they're, you know, even though they're clearly a minor, still scan them to get them off your radar. So here comes a clipper. So I'm going to boost out there to meet it. Now, you'll note I've got 411 pips. I tend to keep them like that in this ship. It's all you need. But occasionally, if you've got to chase somebody down, I might go 0-4-2. Right. So what am I actually doing? If you look at the space dust, you'll see I'm actually going down. I'm holding the down thruster. And most of the time I'm in combat, I'm holding the down thruster. And what that does, it circles around them. If I let go of it, I'll go towards it. So when you get the right position, pitch right up and then up thrust. And you're right alongside him like that. And you've got him where you want him. So I'll go through that a couple of more times. This is if you're not used to combat. I mean, everybody's got their own techniques. Here's a Viper. You'll notice I'm already down thrusting. That's to stop him from going over my head. When you're down thrusting, he can't do that so easily. Because as he goes over, and I'm pitching up, and you can see what's happening. He can't get over my head like that. So he's right where I want him all the time. Look at the space dust. You see the down thrust. Boom, he's gone. Another one. This is a good spawn. I was hoping that we'd have a bad one, then I could show you how to get a good one, which I'll have to explain instead. So he's just a pirate, but you want to kill them all. I'm going to tell you a little bit about spawns in a minute, but I just want to go through while they're all coming nice. So he's obviously not a miner, so he's probably just a basic pirate. Yeah, take him out. And you get a bounty from them, you know, in a good session. You know, in a 3-hour session, you might get 50 million in bounty as well. So every bit counts. Right, now when you're not sure, oh, it's a square top there. But what you can always do is look at your contacts panel. So any now with a name is a ship that you haven't scanned. So Federal dropship, all the big ships, apart from a gunship, are always pirates. So he's just wanted. I can't hit him at this range. I'm going to go over there. This is where you need the speed. You see how quickly I can catch him up. So once you get to about 3 kilometers, start shooting. I mean, some of these combat techniques apply to anything. You'll see I'm using the down thruster again now. So I'm actually moving all the time. Not necessarily makes it. You can use side thrust as well. And with the rocks, same thing. You know, use your down thruster and you won't bump into them. You know, you go round them. Oops, I've got one behind. You get the point. Right, so now I don't know which of those is a potential target. So I look at me and think, the only one that I haven't seen before, oh, is now just a diamondback come. It's an asp. It was there before. 12 kilometers away, so I've got a boost. So this is where, as they thin out from the initial one, you've got to keep scooting backwards and forwards. So he's gone, so there's a diamondback. Oh, it's a dropship again. And he's in a wing. No, he's a novice. So, always take the wing mates first because they tend to run away. So, same thing, holding him down thruster so he can't get over the head. There he goes, up thrust bit now. Boom, he's gone. The last thing you want them doing is, like, if you just stand there, they'll go over. They're always trying to, here he goes, trying to get over. But I'm in full reverse and got my thruster going. I'm now down thrusting again. He's tilting towards me, so he can't get over me. Boom, he's gone. So, they look like miners. So now we've got to scan all three because otherwise you don't know who you haven't scanned when you look at your panel. So that one and that. That's all three of them done. So now we don't know, so we look at the panel. Cobra. It's the only one possible. Here he comes. So when you get those double chevrons, they're coming towards you. Some fighting in a bit, we'll go there afterwards. So there's two of these. So we'll take him first. So I'm down thrusting. And I'm at full reverse as well while he's coming towards me. Now I'm going forwards again because he doesn't seem to want to approach. Same for the next one. I'm now back, going backwards so he can't get behind me. as he seems to just face me. I'm not thrusting yet. Didn't need to. Right, so where did that other fighting go? It's gone now. Oh, there it is. Let's go over there. Just an eagle. You can tag them at 6 kilometers. You can't really kill them like that. But that is... You can still get a kill then, especially if the police... I don't know where the police are. This is excellent. No police there. Oh, there's one. Target destroyed. Sometimes they don't come for a bit. They turn up later. There's a whole lot of fighting in the distance. So you need to use your eyes as well as your panel. And while you're fighting... You want to keep an eye on the radar. You can actually see ships spawning in, especially wings of three. So this is normally a case where I need more pips to engines. But I need to tag this one for now. There could be that the police are just finishing off. But once you've got landed that shot, there is two things you need to do to get credited with the kill. One, you need to land a shot and turn in red. And the second one, the data in the scan on the left, bottom left of your HUD, needs to show that is wanted. If you kill him too quick, before you get a chance to scan a ship, that one's just gone. See what I mean? The police just got that one. If you kill a ship before that scan completes, you don't get credited with the kill. So don't be too quick. So the moment a ship lands a shot on you, you already get that information, like you've as if you've scanned it, even if it shoots you from behind. So, I've targeted that at Type 9, and on the bottom left of my screen, see, it's Type 9. There's no information about it other than its name. In order to get the kill, if I was killing it, you need the rest of the information. Bit weird. I don't think it used to be like that, but it's definitely how it is now. So I've just seen on the radar, something drops on the other side. So when it's not much about, look for the flashing ones, because they're the ones at the extreme range. Often diamondbacks and things like that will come in, and they won't resolve on the radar until they're about 3 kilometres. Let's see what this one is. I can see it. There it is. There is a diamondback. See, it's about 2.5 kilometres. So we don't know. Be careful. They do troll you. You can get clean ones from time to time. And you get... In some spawns, you get an Imperial Courier and Imperial Eagle or a Viper just flying round. And then eventually they fly out and go away after about half an hour. And then another pair or similar wing flies in. And they just go round and round and round. And they've often got square tops. So and you keep targeting, oh, I've already done that one before, you know, and it's sort of waste time. So here we are up here now. I'm looking at the radar, just seeing them spawn in. Here they come. A vulture, so I'll take this wingmate, Cobra. Always the lowest one first. So, stop going past him, I've already got my down thruster going. And now I've let go of it, because he's sort of going up a bit. Right, now I've gone reverse, pitch up a bit. Where's the vulture gone? There he is. Three more just come in there. Oh no, they've got jumped out, I think. So you don't have to panic about wingmates shooting you or anything like that. None of them can do much damage. So I'm at reverse. You get a feel for, you know, throttle and stuff. So there we go again. But the down thrust and up thrust stops them from getting behind you. See, the idea is that to pitch up and down thrust. So that, I think that was those three that just came in. So we've got to scan them now to get them off the list. So there's one behind me by the looks of it. Right, here we go. Viper. Down thrusting so I don't go past him. So I'm going sort of to the side. With down thrust, you're going sort of to the side rather than towards. So I'm down thrusting all the time. Notice none of them have got behind me yet. So just shoot them all the time. That's the quickest way to kill them. So I know a lot of people are asking me, oh, I'll try shooting them, but They just boost over my head all the time. Yeah, that's what they, that's their tactics. It's very frustrating if you just sit there and let them do it. Well, that's what they'll do. But I always say they can't get behind you if you're going backwards and pitching up. But best is to down thrust at the same time. And then a big ship, like we haven't had any competent ones, but when you get the competent ones, they got the old reverse ski thing, and it does defeat them, and that you sort of rotate around them while shooting them. So what's this? He's still a novice. I'll take his wingmate first. So if you boost towards something and you're already too close, immediately hit down, side, up, thrust or something like that, and it'll bleed all the boost out sideways, so you'll sort of boost round instead of towards. So here we go again. Same situation, he's just sitting up there while I shoot him. Under attack. Target destroyed. It's an aspect, could be either. Yeah, it's clean. So I look at the list. Diamondback. He's running. Surge detected means that he's running already. No chance of catching him. If it's 5 kilometres away, you have got a chance of catching. So I do tend to chase them then. If it's any less than five, not a mostly harmless one. He's a gunship. He could be a miner, so don't be too quick. Just wanted. No, I'm full throttle. Right, here we go. Down thrust, now up thrust just to steady. There we go, right where we want him. Down thrust. Now, somebody scanned me. I hope you have something good in your hold. He's a pirate. So note his name, Martin. Have a look at the list. Where's Martin? There he is down the bottom. So you know he's a pirate. You can shoot him straight away as soon as you got him in your sights. But don't be too quick. Because if he blows up before the scan completes, so you can start shooting. But we got the scan now, we can finish him off. Because if like, a sidewinder can go, you can one-shot them. So be careful. So keep an eye on their shields. If you do a shot and the shields are still there, you sort of see the lasers bouncing off. If the shields are still there, he can fire another one. But if the shields, a lot of them are shieldless, so if the shields are gone, don't be too keen to shoot them. Wait till you got that scan and it says wanted before finishing off. So what we got, an eagle. So I think you're getting the hang of it. Oh, it's two. I don't know where his wing. Oh, they're together. So let's take the eagle out first. No, his wingmate's gone. You always choose the wrong one. It's like, there's not many police about at the moment. Now, this is a very good spawn. This is perfect, what you want. Plenty of targets. And not too much interest by the police. And they come in waves, you know, like you'll get like 4 or 5, you know, if you're lucky, a couple of wings or something like that. And then it might go quiet for a minute, so don't panic. They'll be back. So just fly always towards where all the yellow is, where it's flashing. So we've got an adder, wing of adders, by the looks of it. So who's in this wing and what they're doing? So the moment it's scanned, you know they're pirates. So you can start shooting. I've got the wingmate target, not the one who scanned me. But get him. And what you want is for the other ones to shoot you before. So you got a red. So I just used the next hostile one, the button I was telling you about. So I got him straight away. Quite often the wingmate will not shoot until after the other one's dead. It's a bit of a pain. So we don't know where he is now. He's probably going to run. So we've got to try and find him. Maybe down the bottom somewhere. Where's he gone? That one, James Bradley. Is he running? Yeah, he's running. So I mustn't kill him too quickly. So we scanned him now, so. Boom. Target destroyed. Yeah, I probably make it look easy keeping them in front of me all the time. It does take a bit of practice, but after you've done a few sessions, you'll get the hang of it. Python, it's the only one. There he is, shooting at the beast. So I can tag him now, even at this range. Just a good thing to do while you come in, because you can tag them up to 6 kilometers with the long range lasers. So use your thrusters, you know, to avoid the rocks, you know, as you come to go sideways and up and downwards. He's running, so I've got to get a bit closer. But you don't want to overshoot, so I'm just going to use my up thruster now to slow down a bit. Boom, got him. When you're chasing them down, it's very easy to overshoot them. And then they end up jumping before you can get them back in your sights. So be careful with that. Another thing, nearly all the big ships have turrets. So even when you're behind them, they're shooting you. But the turrets don't do much damage. So it's no problem. So Professor English, I'm already lining up my next target. He's just scanned me. So all I want is his name. Professor English, there he is. I can shoot him straight away, as long as I don't kill him too quick. So he looks shieldless, so yeah, 65%. He's not last long. And there was the police were shooting somebody. Who are they shooting? That one. Tag him straight away, then don't fire, because he could be about to go. There you go. Finish it off. Yeah, it's really frustrating. You shoot them too soon, and you don't get the kill. So you want to just tag them, and then it's just a question of whether he'll die, whether the police will kill him before the scan completes. Oh, I can shoot that one. I know he's a pilot. When they're pointing at you like that, and you get scan detected, it's pretty obvious who it is. So you're good to go. Just trying to think whether there's anything else I can tell you. Right. From time to time, you're going to get a bounty on you because you're going to shoot a clean ship accidentally. It's quite easy to do, especially if you're trying to do it quickly. But it's no problem. Immediately, some of the ships start shooting you, but none of them can do much. So just run out of the resource extraction. So just turn at right angles to it, boost up into the sky, and as soon as you're clear of mass slot, get your frameshift drive. So you can stay here wanted, but you can't, like, when you get the bounty, you can't, whoops, crash into rocks again. When you got the bounty, you can't just stay here because all the ships will be shooting you, especially the police. But if you jump out and back in again, even though you're still wanted, they seem to have forgotten about it. So I don't know what that's all about, but it works. And to clear the bounty, well, at the station where you get the missions, yes, occasionally about 1 in 4 trips, sometime during the session, a wing of much higher ranked ships will spawn in. Can be Anaconda, FDL, or a Python. They're the ones to look out for. And what happens is you get on automatic pilot, just killing them all. You target them and shoot them, like this competent gunship. And all of a sudden, this Python you see is actually dangerous or deadly. Now, normally that's not a problem. It's just going to take you longer to kill them. But they have normally shield cell banks. It's always good to ram them if you can. Speed things up a bit. So those higher ranked ships, they often have shield cell banks. And with only laser weapons, it does. If you're not careful, they can use those before you can get their shields down each time. So that suddenly makes it into a very long battle because you spend all the time whittling their shields down, and then they charge them right back up and you're back to start again. So look out for those. And obviously, if they're in a wing, you know, I've seen two deadly pythons and a deadly FDL all in a wing. Now they're going to do you some damage, so you might even have to run away from them if you start on them. So look out for those. It could have happened to me now because I've not been concentrating, so just be careful of that if all of a sudden, you know, pythons in particular and FDLs, they're the main ones, but occasionally an anaconda. Somebody scanned me. Oops, that one's gone, so let's be that one. Bob. Yeah, that's the only real danger here, those high rank ships. Oh, I've hit a clean one. So let's sit over now. So what you have to do, so I was busy talking instead of concentrating. Put your weapons away. See, a few ships are shooting me. No danger, I'm wanted. Just, go on, weapons, go away. Right, get your frame shift drive going. Sorry it's taking so long. I forgot that I changed computers. So hopefully I can show you a bit more about spawns now. Right, so just fly out a little bit, throttle back, turn around and go back in, and they've forgotten all about your misdemeanors or your felony crimes. It's not really a misdemeanor shooting somebody. So here we go. So again, quite a busy spawn by the looks of it. No square tops yet. You know, sometimes it does take a while to come. Triangle ones probably miners, but can be pirates. So you have to evaluate. So these all look like, don't know about that one, but all, everyone else looks like a miner. Yeah. So you should still scan them. There's a couple of square tops underneath me now. Those two down there. Oh, it's a clipper. So that's a good sign. Big ships. Normally, a spawn with big ships in is reasonable. So we'll take his wingmate first, even though I've scanned him. We know he's a pirate. Oop, forgot about my pips. Right, where's the clip up? Target destroyed. So we'll just have a look at the spawn again in a minute. So a small ship spawn can be with just small ships. Now what, yeah, let me just explain about that again. The spawns, sometimes you get only small ships. Sometimes you get only big ships as pirates. So they're clean, which is a bit suspicious. Other times you get a mixed spawn of small and big ships. So it's not so common to get an unbusy spawn when there's big ships coming. But we don't know whether this is just a big ship spawn at the moment until we see whether we're getting small ships as well. So when it's just big ships, it's normally pretty quiet. And sometimes when it's small ships, it's just fairly quiet. So if you got both, it's normally okay, at least. So we had a clipper. The wingmates don't count. You know, that's so far, we've got no evidence this is a mixed spawn. So it's a big ship with or without a wing. And if it's just big ships, they're normally pretty sparse, so not worth hanging around. So I'm not happy with it by now. You know, we've had two targets, the word mission targets, and there don't seem to be anything else coming. So you can just hang about for a few minutes, see what happens, but so now what we do, we log. Back to the main menu. Continue. and just start again. You'd be back there. Ideally, you want to do it within 3 kilometers of the center. So the first thing you got to do is now retarget the resource extraction site so you know where the center is. Switch on your lights. Oop, because by default they're off. And then you look at spawn again. So we got a square top there. Good sign. Bring your weapons out. So it's a small ship, so it doesn't tell us anything. Yep. So we'll have a look at the others in a minute. Fortunately, you've got to kill them to see what's happening, so I can't just like stop this and show you. So there's quite a few ships about. There's no police, so this is looking good. You know, the signs are good. But not many square top, not many new ones dropping in. So there could be a few pirates about. So he might be one. No, he's clean. So it's just a question of scanning them all until you've got the name of every one of them. Right, so these are pirates because they're scanning me. So here we go. So I'll take his wingmate first, but I've got to be careful not to kill him too quick because I haven't scanned him yet. So here we go. It's 3. There's a wingmate. Oh, no, that was him. His wingmate hasn't started shooting yet, so I don't know where he is. I'll shoot the main man. Oh, he's chaffing. Right, now I'm going to go for the other one because I can't shoot that one while he's chaffing anyway. Yeah, they've forgotten that I'm wanted now. It's no problem because I can pay it off when I go back. So it's nothing extra. It's only 3. Yeah, you don't want to kill them because if you suddenly realise that you're shooting the wrong one, stop. Don't carry on and kill them. Because if you kill them, you get notoriety. So you've got to wait 2 hours before you get the services from the station. Before you can clear it. And I think when you get a full bounty, they do take more interest in you here. I'm not too sure. I think last time I did get a couple of them suddenly turn on me. Which obviously is worrying because if you don't notice that they're clean, you're going to get more notoriety. When you finish them off, you get more notoriety. So still some things to look out for, but you know, you learn by your mistakes on that. But don't say I didn't warn you about all these things. There is a lot to it. There's a lot of ifs and buts. But it's easy for me because I must have done literally hundreds of visits. So I know exactly what I'm doing. It's only because I'm talking to you lot, trying to explain things, think about what I'm going to say, that I'm not fully concentrating on what I'm doing. So, we haven't seen any big ships, so this looks like a small ship spawn. So you notice it's not quite as busy as the other one. It's not a disaster. Guys, where's he going? Yeah, so if you want really fast, this isn't it. So, you know, like, sometimes in a hurry, I've got like 2.5 hours to play before I'm meeting up with somebody, but I've got to do all the missions in that time. So in a spawn like this, I go, it's not fast enough. So I would be logging to try and get a better one. So let's just log again. So sometimes you have to log 4, 5, 6 times, sometimes longer. So we got square tops, good sign. Got to switch, target the resource extraction site, go back to contacts, come on this side, go to ship. Oop, missed it. Switch the lights on, get the weapons out, and here we go. I thought I'd targeted. So the square tops at the beginning are nearly always pirates and mainly mission targets as well. So there's another one. So we completed a mission. Oops, he's got behind me that one. I was a bit slow. I was thinking about something. So that one. He's running. So, yeah, you can, like, when you first drop in, sometimes it's a lot and then they fizzle out. So just be careful of that. And other times, there's not too many and then it sort of builds up. So sometimes you have to wait about 5-10 minutes to get a feel for it. And obviously in the beginning, when it comes straight at you like that, it's difficult. So it's still the same applies, up thrust, handbrake turn. Yeah, as I say, it takes... they're coming quite quick. We've got a couple of asps there, so that must be in by the process of elimination. Yeah, not too quick. Right. Oh, looks like those asps have jumped. Oh no, it's still there. Maybe they're miners. Yeah, so always scan them all, clean or, you know, even if they're miners, because what you want is to be able to look at that list, and any name of a ship there is a new one's come in, so you could target him and then see if he's a pirate or not. Yeah, he's moving, it's a good sign. No, he's clean, it's just repositioning. So, then a spawn like this, what you've got to do now is go for where they're all flashing. We'll just boost over there. Trouble is, it's often behind you and in front of you, so just choose a side. And whichever way you choose, it'd be the wrong way. So this is a sort of a medium spawn, I would say. So, is with a wing, mate. That's that one. So we take that one first. So, you really want the ships to shoot you. So he's starting now. So now I know where he is for next. And the moment they shoot you, of course... you've effectively scanned them because you got the information. Yeah, the worst place for them to be is like coming straight at you because you don't know which way they're going to go. You don't know whether they're going up or down. And sometimes they hover in front of your face and it's really difficult to get them. They're just to the side. By the time you turn that, they're on the other side. And they're not even moving, hardly. So this one looks sort of okay. It's a small ship spawn, but a fairly busy one. So, oh, but that's shown you something. It does take a bit of practice to see, so I won't get that one. So either the scan's completed, it's too late. See, I didn't get the bounty for him. Because it's when they go to 0%. If they go to 0% before you see that wanted, you don't get it. So you've got to be very quick to tag, but not too quick to kill. So that's it. Yeah, we've seen a couple of spawns now. Right, back safely at the station now. I took off from the station 1612. I touched down again at 18:44, and that's just about 2.5 hours. And I've added up all the missions. That I had 18 missions, and they came to 282.8 million, but I also got 24 million in bounty money, so it comes to just over 500 million. So 2.5 hours works out at 200 million an hour, more or less, exactly. And that's normally what I get. If you've got any ideas or comments, put them in the comments. I always try and answer them, and I much appreciate when people give ideas. You know, they see flaws in what I'm doing, or they find they've done it and they do it differently and they think it's better. Yeah, please write that down. You know, I'm not frightened of criticism. It all helps us all learn together how to do these things. So that's my main goal. For you, I don't make any money at this. I just do it to help other people out. One last thing. If you mess up, tag somebody, the wrong ship, and get a bounty like I did. When you get back to the station, the first thing you should do, so you don't forget, is see this guy, the interstellar factor. There he is. The bounty will be there. He'll take it off you, and that'll be the end of it. So whatever you do, don't hand it in at this guy. It's dead easy because you're used to coming back here and clicking this guy to cash in your bounties. And you click it in, and you see, up here you've got an outstanding fine. You click on that, and next thing you know, you're in jail. So once you've clicked it, there's no way back. So whatever you do, don't click on this guy when you've got a bounty. That's it. So, right, I'll see you in another video in the future sometime, hopefully.